What's up, Tim Sykes, millionaire mentor and trader, here in the hot seat answering your questions. I got my phone, I gotta put this down. A lot of people are asking me, you know, you're under the PDT, the pattern day trader rule, so you only have 3 day trades per week. What do you do? It's not ideal, I'll tell you that. You know, I wish that you could trade freely, but at the same time, I'll tell you that most newbies are, you know, really helped by the pattern day trader rule. Too many people, you know, you'll just trade all over the place. You'll just, you know, churn and burn your account, I think is the term. So it's good that you're limited, but you have to be choosy. Trading overnight is really, I think, the solution, specifically and meticulously, not just trading anything, not just holding anything overnight, but utilizing your small account to your advantage, where you can take a small position and you can get out very quickly near the market open the next day. Big accounts can't get out that quickly, so they can't take a lot of trades like that. And then also utilizing really the OTC market, which has no after hours and no pre-market trading. So if an OTC play has good news and it's, let's say, a first green day pattern, I'll post a link to a blog post about the first green day underneath this. Please leave a comment also underneath this video saying if you like to hold overnight or if you like to hold intraday. I'm curious what you like. And also smash that like button, because why not? But back to OTCs, if a company has good news and it's OTC and it's a big percent gainer and it's closing strongly, anybody who hears about it, which is most people in OTCs, they're not very meticulous, anytime between 4 p.m. Eastern and 9:30 a.m. Eastern the next day, that is 17 and a half hours of which they can hear about the good news or the stock, or someone can send them, you know, a text message or something like that, where like news spreads overnight. There's no way to get that buy executed. If you hear about a stock, an OTC stock that's on fire at 4:01 p.m. Eastern, 4:02 p.m. Eastern, 10:01 p.m. Eastern, 1 a.m. Eastern, 7 a.m. Eastern, all of those buy orders, because people like tips, you know? You shouldn't follow any tips, you shouldn't follow anyone's alerts, but people can't help it, especially newbies. All of those buy orders pile up right at 9:30 a.m. Eastern. So it leads to a lot of gap ups, a lot of, you know, morning spikes, especially because a lot of the buy orders don't get executed right away at the market open. Let's say there's 700 people or 7,000 people who wanna buy right at the open. There's probably not 700 or 7,000 sellers. So the price has to rise. You can sell into that rise by anticipating it if you recognize the setup. I know that we're talking about like what's working best in 2021, but this has worked for me for 20 plus years. My first $100,000 gain in chapter 6 of my best-selling book, which I want you to read, click the link below. I'm gonna post the link to an American hedge fund. You can buy it on Amazon for 20 bucks, or you can click that link and get it for free. Chapter 6 is where I made 100 grand. The company said they're gonna be on TV over the weekend. They were gonna hype up their miracle technology, which eventually failed, like pretty much all OTC technologies do. And guess what? I bought it on a Friday afternoon, I sold it on a Monday morning, made over 100 grand. Read chapter 6, recognize those catalysts still happen. Companies put out press releases, they say, look, we're gonna be on TV, we're gonna be in the news. It becomes kind of an upcoming news play. And again, anybody who hears about it, over the weekend, this works especially well on Fridays, they have to put in their buy order. Monday mornings, you get the gap up, you get the morning spike, whether it's 5%, 10%, 20%, 30%. This is, for me, a no-brainer if you have a small account. You don't have to waste a day trade, and you know, whether you buy 200 shares, 500 shares, 1,000 shares, 5,000 shares, you're using your small account to your advantage. You can get out very easily. And on that first $100,000 day that I had 20 plus years ago, I sold it right near the market open because I was freaked out that I just made 6 figures as a college freshman. But I didn't have to be quick. The news and the hype spread a whole nother day. I would have made another 100 grand had I sold it on Tuesday instead of Monday. So it's not always just about getting out at the market open, but that's the point of trading like a sniper, being meticulous, not believing the company's technology, not believing promoters or hype or any of that BS. It's taking apart the trading day and looking for inefficiencies. This is my secret to my success. This is the secret to my success of teaching too. You know, people wonder like, how are Tim Sykes' students so successful? Who are the top students? Understand, most students, most traders lose money if you're not meticulous. But my top students and I have learned to be meticulous. We've learned to really deconstruct the trading day and be in these little trades. In a few hundred dollars, maybe a few thousand dollars, maybe you can size up, maybe you can make 10,000 or even six figures in a day. I have some students who have made seven figures over time. Some students make eight figures over time. That's the secret. That's the key. So also understand that you don't necessarily have to try to make six, seven, eight figures all on overnight trades. You make whatever you can on these overnight trades, and then it adds up so that you can escape the pattern day trader rule, and then you can trade more. Most of my top students are doing intraday trades, and they're, you know, being very quick with bigger size. But in order to get over the pattern day trader rule, I highly encourage you not just to add money to any account. You know, that's kind of like cheating your way out of the pattern day trader rule. I think that it's a good test to see, can you get over $25,000? Or, you know, you can have two different brokerage accounts and then you can make 6 day trades per week if you really wanted to get over that. But as a newbie, you do not need to make that many trades. As a newbie or as someone who's just beginning with a small account, start getting in the habit. Where can you learn to make rather predictable 5% or 10% or 15% type setups where there is lower risk? What if you're wrong? What if the news isn't as good? What if there's not a lot of buy orders at the open? You have to be able to get out very quickly. Again, this is where having a small size comes in handy. I would never go all in. I would never use leverage. I would never be like, this works every time. Because what if it doesn't? And then instead of an avalanche of buy orders, you have an avalanche of sell orders and you're stuck in one of the morning panics that I like to dip by after the panic. But if you're trying to sell right at the open and the stock is down 20, 30%, you might not get executed, especially if you have big size. So you have to be careful. You can be wrong on any trade. You can, you know, lose big on any trade. If you ever get too cocky, if you ever take too big a position size, the market will humble you and bring you back down to size. So for me, it's about teaching, you know, kind of how to stay in the lane, stay in your groove, where you can try to make a few hundred dollars, try to make a few thousand dollars. Like I said, it adds up over time if you take more good trades than not. But I want a big percent gain. I want a news catalyst that will travel. If you're familiar with my last Orlando conference, I bought Dan Bilzerian's play overnight because he posted about it on his Instagram. No one could buy it after hours. No one could buy it pre-market. So the thing gapped up 30%. I actually sold. Then the thing, you know, doubled within 15 minutes of me selling. So I underestimated it. But again, I took advantage of the inefficiency where anybody who heard about Dan Bilzerian's weed company back then, guess what? They bought it and all those buy orders, or they tried to buy it, all those buy orders piled up right at the open and it led to a 30% gap up and it led to a 100% morning spike. The stock has never recovered since. It was just that first time with people in Dan Bilzerian's, you know, wide-ranging number of followers hearing about the stock for the first time. So sometimes it's not just about how great the company is in the long run. In fact, most of these OTCs, most of these penny stocks fail. But you can take advantage of that small window of opportunity, that informational inefficiency. So let me know in the comments if you like this, if you like overnight trades as opposed to intraday trades. I'll teach you. This is what I've been doing for 2+ decades.